Okay, good afternoon, everybody. Okay, so areas up to 23 we discussed, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, we'll continue from 25. Today evening, yesterday I thought it was Wednesday and today Thursday. Other day taking KVPA classes today. It's okay. Today evening onwards, I'll be taking the KVPA classes once again. I think KVPA 2018 paper question number 1 to 10 we discussed. 11 onwards will continue in today's class. Class will be from 3:25 to 4:45, 40 minutes. Okay, now the area of the region bounded by the curve y equal to tan x, tangent drawn to the curve at pi by 4 and x axis. Okay, so this is a graph of tan. And at pi by 4, I can draw tangent. So this is x-axis, this is a curve, and this is a tangent. So I will have this much area. I have to find that. So I'll draw a little bigger. I have to find this area. So I can do upper curve minus lower curve. But this is 0, this is pi by 4. I don't know what is this value. Or I can find area under the curve and subtract this triangle area also. Okay, fine. I can give some names if you want to. Okay, please. This is pi by 4, comma 1. This curve is y equal to tan x. Dy by dx is secant square x and dy by dx at pi by 4 comma 1 is secant square pi by 4, which is 2. Okay, now equation of tangent. Y minus y1 equal to dy by dx at that point into x minus x1. This look for tangent, we know that. So y minus 1 equal to 2 into x minus 5 by 4. I want to find this x-intercept. So I can put y equal to 0 and try to find x. X will come 5 by 4 minus of. So this point is 5 by 4 minus of comma 0. That means this length is 1 by 2, this height is 1. In fact, because the slope is 2 and this height is 1, I can say this height is 1 by 2 straight away. So if you want to do integration, I have to do 0 to pi by 4 minus half upper curve minus lower curve. And then pi by 4 minus half to pi by 4 area under the line. But I just want to do the triangle part. Okay, so somebody can, if they want to write, they want to find OAB area, OAC area. That is OAB area minus CAB area. That's what I wanted to do. OAB area is total 0 to pi by 4 tan x dx. CAB is just a triangle with the base 1 by 2 and height 1. Okay, so tan x integral is log mod secant x. With the 0 to pi by 4 minus 1 by 2. So when I put pi by 4, it is log root 2. When I put 0, it is log 1 minus log 1 minus 1 by 2. This power 1 by 2, I can take it out. It will be half log 2 minus 1 by 2. So the triangle part I found without integration. If somebody want to use integration for that also, they can use. If anybody any doubt which region they're asking or how we found, please ask if you have doubt about this. Okay, I'm going to erase 25. Anybody any doubt or anybody needs more time? So in this chapter especially, theory is less. It is a matter of experience where you try a lot of questions, where you should be able to draw the graph and identify which region they want. And you have to see whether upper curve minus lower curve is better. Or from figure only can you tell or right curve minus left curve is better and all. Okay, 27. I think this can be very first question, very simple. Cos x, we all know graph will be like this. They want between 0 and pi by 4. Very simple. This is y equal to cos x. Area of the region bounded by y equal to cos x, x axis, and x equal to 0 and x equal to pi by 4. Oh, this is very simple. 0 to pi by 4 cos x. So cos x integral is sin x. 0 to pi by 4, which is 1 by root. Y equal to log x plus c base c. They want this area. First of all, with the coordinate axis. So we have to draw the graph. Only log x, the graph is like this. We know that. What about log x plus c is the horizontal shift. You have to move, if it is x minus h, move towards right side by h. Plus h, you have to move leftwards by e units. So actually the graph of this will come like this. Same graph, little more towards left. It will intersect x-axis also, negative side y-axis. Very little set y-axis and x is 0, y is 1. So this is 0 comma 1. What is this point? Log of something will be 0 when inner part is 1. So when x is 1 minus c. So this point is 1 minus c comma 0. This is 0 comma 0. How did I get 1 minus c? Log x plus c 0 means x plus c equal to 1, x equal to 1 minus c. That's where y coordinate is 0. So once you draw the graph, right, x-axis, y-axis, and the graph, they are bounding what this region. They want area bounded by the coordinate axis and the curve. So just you want area under the curve between what to what? Between this x value to this x value. So integral 1 minus e to 0 log of x plus e dx. I can take x plus e as t. Then this will become, when I put x, this will become 1. This will become e log t dt. How are we going to integrate by parts? Into 1 you take and apply by parts, you'll get t log t minus t into 1 by t. So I'm just writing log t into 1 dt and applying by parts. This with limits 1 to e, this also 1 to e. Here t will cancel. When I put e, it is e log e. And when I put 1, log 1 is 0. And that is integral is t with the limits 1 to e. So this is e log e means e only because log e is 1. And the t upper limit is this. So plus another e minus 1, which is 2e minus. Something wrong. That is because there's a minus. So E and E will cancel, will get 1. Okay, so both 27, 29 are easy. 27 is very easy because the graph is just simple, 0 to pi by 4, I didn't back up. Here, log x shifted towards left side by u units. So that is this one. So earlier it was 1 here. Now that came to u units back. That's why 1 minus e. Okay, so just you know this exponent, area under the curve of that simple byproducts. Anybody any doubt in 29? 31, anybody want to tell the answer without writing anything? One is a very easy question. Anybody want to tell? Yes, answer is 1 because the step function, greatest integer function between 1 to 2, it is always 1. So between 1 and 2, it is step function 1, closed here, open here. They want this area. You don't need any integration. This is a simple square. This width is 1, this height is 1. So 1, that's it. Nothing to write. Simple step function. One unit. Okay, 33. Y equal to 1 minus mod x. It's a very simple graph. Mod x will be like this. This is a graph of mod x. Minus mod x will be like this. This is a graph of minus mod x. And then 1 unit means move upward. So it will be moving upward 1 unit. So this is actually 1, 0. This is 0, 1. This is minus 1, 0. This is a graph of y equal to 1 minus mod x. You want area and between the curve and x-axis. That's all. So don't worry about y-axis. X-axis is there and the curve is like this. So they want this total triangle. This total. You can easily see base is 2 and height is 1. You don't need integration here. Oh, I can do integration, but not required. Base is 2 and height is 1, which is 1. All right, so both are here, easier from the figure. Okay, 35 also should be easy from the figure. Let us see. One is mod x minus 1. Another one is 1 minus mod x. So this is same figure. 1 minus mod x is like this. Mod x minus 1. Take mod x and decrease down by 1 unit. So it is actually like this. It is actually square. This is 1, 0. This is 0, 1, minus 1, 0, 0, -1. These two together is y equal to 1 minus mod. These two together is y equal to mod x minus 1. I can do upper curve minus lower curve, but not required. It is a very simple square, I'm sure. It is double of the previous area. Okay, directly square, you can say this length is root 2. Because this is 1, this is 1. And you can say area equal to side whole square, which is 2 units. This is a graph of y equal to x square plus 1 more upward by 1 unit. If I take reciprocal of this, when this is 1, reciprocal is also 1. But when this goes increasing, the reciprocal will decrease. And finally, when it reaches infinity, the reciprocal will become 0. When I take 2 by 1 plus x square, it will be like this. This point is 0, 1. This y equal to 2 by 1 plus x square. 0 comma 2 at 0, it is 2.
Because the denominator is minimum at 0, so the whole thing is a maximum at 0. As x is increasing, denominator is increasing. So 2 by that is decreasing. Finally, at infinity, it's tending to 0. And moreover, it is even function. So right side, whatever is the graph, left side, same graph. Okay, so this is a graph of y equal to x square. Move upward 1 unit. Take reciprocal, count multiply. Now we want to draw these two together in one place. So one is a curve like this, and another is a curve like this. And they want, this is x square. This is y equal to 2 by 1 plus x square. We want this area. So it is upper curve minus lower curve. We have to know the points of intersection. So when I equate x square to 2 by x square plus 1, I can solve a quadratic equation. I think I'll get x square equal to 1. I'll get x square equal to 1. I'll also get minus 2, but I cannot take that. X square equal to minus 2 will come, I cannot take. You can do cross multiplication, get a quadratic equation, we'll get this. X square equal to 1 means x equal to plus or minus 1. So this is minus 1, this one. Okay, so first thing is we have drawn the graph, then understood which region we want, then what are the x values, where the boundary values, upper curve minus lower curve. So area now. Integral minus 1 to 1, upper curve is 2 by 1 plus x square and lower curve is x square. 1 by 1 plus x square integral is tan inverse x. If one is an even function, the total you can even write 2 times 0 to 1, 2 by 1 plus x square minus x square dx also. That is 2 times 2 tan inverse x minus x cube by 3 with limit 0 to 1. When I put 0, everything is 0, but before that, I put 1. That will be 2 tan inverse 1, which is pi by 4, minus 1 by 3. Okay. It is 2 times pi by 4 minus 1 by 3. That will be pi minus 2 by 3. Okay, usually in this, I think integration is not that complicated. Mainly drawing the graphs, understanding the region. Try to write this integral setup of that integration is. All of you studied about waves in a string, right? Transverse waves. Anybody any doubt regarding 37? Okay, 39, we have to draw a graph somewhat carefully to understand the function. Y equal to ex log x. First of all, when it is positive, it is negative. But log x is not defined for negative values. So I have to talk about 0 and 1. Anything more than 1, log 1, log is positive. At 1, it is 0. Between 0 to 1, log is negative. So x is positive, it will be negative. Before 0, it is not even defined. I'm just understanding the sign of this. Okay. If you want to know when it is increasing, when it is decreasing, you can find dy by dx. You may not need all that, but first year in calculus, you studied about curve sketching, how to draw a curve. You have to say when it is positive, when it is negative, and where it is zero. And when it is increasing, when it is decreasing, where it is the local maxima, where is the local minima. If you know all that, you can draw the curve. So when I differentiate this product rule, x into derivative of log x is 1 by x. Log x into derivative of x is 1. So finally, got e into 1 plus log x. So if I see where derivative is 0, where it is positive, where it is negative, everything depends on this. Where 1 plus log x is 0, log x equal to minus 1, x equal to e power minus 1, which is 1 by e. So you take 1 by e and 0. Anything more than 1 by e, it is positive. Between 0 to 1 by e, negative. At 1 by e, it is 0. That means between 0 to 1 by e, the function is decreasing. After 1 by e, the original function is increasing. Okay, starting at 0, that means x value is somewhat close to 0. You cannot take open 0, that is close to 0, open. I want to know at 0, what is the limit of this? I want to know limit extends to 0 plus x log x. In order to remember limits, I want to tell this limit extends to 0 plus x log x. Because when x is reaching 0, log x is becoming minus infinity. All of you know that. Limit x to 0 plus log x equal to minus infinity. Because you know the graph of log x. When x is tending to 0, your values are tending down to minus infinity. So now if you want limit extends to 0 plus x log x, one is becoming 0, one is becoming infinity. Okay, if you want to understand this better, take x equal to 1 by t. If you take x equal to 1 by t, you will get limit t tends to infinity, 1 by t log 1 by t. That is limit t tends to infinity, log 1 by t is minus log t. So I'll get minus log t pi t. So when t is becoming infinity, very big number, log t is also becoming very big, t also become very big. But this is much, much, much bigger compared to this. For example, if you take log x base 2 by x and take x as 2 power 100. 2 power 100 is a very big number. It has some 30 degrees in crores. Crores of crores of crores. When I put the 2 power 100 here, numerator is only 100. Whereas denominator is 2 power 100. Yes, this is also becoming very big. This is becoming very big, but this is much bigger compared to this. 100 by 2 power 100 is a 0.0000, some 28 zeros or something. Very small value. So we know this is becoming infinity, this is becoming infinity, but this is much bigger compared to this. So it is tending to 0. Okay, so even though it is 0 into infinity, but finally it is 0. Not that every time 0 into infinity is 0. You know all the limits are, most of them are like that. Even sin x by x limit at 0, it is 0 into infinity, but it is 1. Anyway, so in total I understood at 0 the limit of this is 0. At 1 also it is 0. Between them it is negative. So if you draw the graph of y is equal to ex log x graph, it will come like this, where this is 1 by e, this is 1. You can see all the details are there here. What is that? At 1, it is 0. At 0, it is tending to 0. Between 0 to 1, it is negative. So that's a below x-axis. After 1, it is positive. Next, between 0 to 1 by e, decreasing. And after 1 by e to infinity, it is increasing. So because of all these things, we are able to draw this graph. That it starts with 0 at 0, open interval, decreases, then increases at 1, it is 0. After that, increases further all the way up to infinity. This alone is a graph of y equal to ex log x. Now let us see the other graph, y equal to log x by x or log x by ex. Okay, please copy all these things. At the end, question may be easy, but to draw this, we understood when it is positive, negative, when derivative is increasing, decreasing, what are the limits and all that. We are not completed. We just drawn ex log x graph. Okay, so you want me to explain once again? Main point, whenever you want to draw a graph, you have to know when it is positive and it is negative, where it is 0. When you equate it to 0, you'll get x equal to 1. Between 0 to 1, log x is negative. After 1, it is positive. That's the first. Next, here it is 0, and the domain is open interval 0 to infinity. So it start at 0, roughly, what is the value I want to know? Limit. That's why I done this limit, I got 0. At 0, it is 0, basically, the limit wise. At 1, it is 0, in between negative. So it has to come down to some negative value and go up, obviously. If you want this value and this value should be same, in between either it should be like this or like this. But it is negative, that's why it was like this. It should have some minimum value. What is that minimum? How do you know? We found the derivative. Understood derivative is 0 at 1 by e, and derivative sign is changing from minus to plus. It is local minima at 1 by e. Between 0 to 1 by e, derivative is negative, so decreasing. After 1 by e, derivative is positive, so it is increasing. After 1, it should be positive and then increases further. Is it okay, Danush? Okay. Just think about it. Copy all these things. If any doubt you ask, otherwise try the next graph of this in the same question. Log x by x. Medicine. Okay, everything is clear, right? Okay, now let us see the second graph of this.
Y is equal to log x by ex. Sine wise it is same. At one it is zero, and after one it is positive. Between zero to one it is negative. Next, coming to derivative, u by v rule, x into derivative log x is 1 by x minus log x into derivative x is 1 by x whole square. So 1 minus log x by ex.
So you can easily see at e derivative is 0 and after e it is negative and before e it is positive up to 0. Because when you take more than e, it will be more than 1. 1 minus that will be negative. So between 0 to e, it should increase. And after e, it should decrease.
Next, what is the limit?
Limit extends to 0 log x by x. Limit extends to 0, it is 0 plus 1 by x into log x. This will become plus infinity. And this will become minus infinity. So it will be minus infinity. You take, let's for example, 1 crore into minus 1,000 to be minus infinity. Okay, so this alone, what is the graph? So at 0, it is minus infinity. At 1, it is 0.
At infinity also, it is 0. I have to write that also. Limit extends to infinity log x by x.
You know, at infinity, this is becoming infinity. This is becoming infinity, but this is much small compared to this. This is very big, so it is 0, you know. At 1 it is 0, at infinity it is 0. So the graph of log x by ex is actually like this. How is that? First, you can see after 1, the graph is above x-axis, positive. Between 0 to 1, negative below. Next, at 1 it is 0, at infinity also it is 0. If it is 0 here, in between positive, it has to go up and come back. At 1 it is 0, at infinity it is 0. And according to derivative also, up to e it is increasing and after that it is decreasing. So at e it has maximum value. Between 0 to negative and at 0 the limit is minus infinity. You can see it is increasing up to e and after e decreasing. So this is satisfied. This is also satisfied and the limits are satisfied. So this is the graph of y equal to log x by ex. Now I have to draw these two graphs together and understand which region they're asked. Okay, so please try to understand. If any doubt, please ask me. Would have given this in advanced material than means, but it's okay. Just one question time. All right. Okay, now let us draw both curves in one place. One is a curve like this. Another is a curve. Okay, the second curve is just drawn like this. This is the first curve that we are seeing. You can easily see they're intersecting at two points. What is that term? Ex log x equal to log x by e. So you can take a log x common on this side and one e common, one x common. We are going to get x square minus 1 by e square equal to 0. We are going to get log x equal to 0 or x square equal to 1 by e square. So that is x equal to 1 or 1 by e. So this side here x is 1 and here it is 1 by e, which happened to be the lowest value of this also, but doesn't matter. So now we want this. So the forget what x-axis, y-axis. One curve is this, one curve is this. So the region bounded by both the curves is this part. It is bounded between 1 by e to 1. Upper curve is this one, log x by, what is this upper curve? Y equal to log x by e. What is this? Y equal to ex log x. You can simply do upper curve minus lower curve. So if you can, without doing all this work, you can, you're able to draw these graphs, then it's very easy question, not very blunt. So required area, integral 1 by e to 1, upper curve is the log x by dx minus lower curve is dx log x dx. How to integrate? The first one is easy because derivative of log x is 1 by x. So I'll get log x whole square by x. Second one, I have to do by parts. So let me put limits 1 by e to 1. Here, ex into log x, sorry, log x into, I have to integrate x, which is x square by 2. Limits 1 by e to 1. Plus integral 1 by e to 1. This will continue, I have to differentiate this. So which is e into 1 by x into x square by 2. So when I put 1, log 1 is 0. And when I put 1 by e, 1 log 1 by e is minus 1, square is 1, so it is 1 by 2. Coming to this, when I put 1, it is 0. When I put 1 by e, this is minus 1. This is minus e square, so minus 1 by 2. And coming to this, one x will cancel, x by 2 will be left, so e x square by 4 with the limits, so 1 by e to 1. So this is minus 1 by 2e, this is also minus 1 by 2e. Here when I put 1, it is e by 4, and when I put 1 by e, it is 1 by 4. So this is minus 1 by e, minus 5 by 4e. So e by 4 minus 5 by 4. The answer is here, yes. Okay, so 39 is quite a bit of work. Drawing the first curve carefully, second curve carefully, understanding which region, what are the limits, and then even integration. Okay, try to understand, copy. If you have any doubt, any part of it, please ask. Okay, anybody any other doubt in this question? You completed try 41, drawing the figure, identify which region and all. So let us see 41. Two power x and 2x minus x square. So y equal to 2 power x. 2x minus x square, I can write x into 2 minus x or minus x into x minus 2. That is 0 at 0 and at 2 it is 0. And quadratic expression, a parabola downward passing through these two. So it will be like this. This is 0, 0. This is 2, 0. What about 2 power x? At 0, it is 1. At 1, this is 1. But at 1, this is 2. So it is increasing very rapidly like this. Oh, there's no intersection at all. 2 power x is always above this because this maximum value is 0, 1, 1. And this is attaining what? And 0 itself. So this is a graph of y equal to 2 power x. So there's no intersection at all. Then what they want then? Between 0 and 2. Oh, draw x equal to 0. And x equal to 2. So they want this area. So very neatly, between two curves, upper curve is clearly given, lower curve is given between 0 to 2. Just upper curve minus lower curve, no complications, nothing. It is simply integral 0 to 2. Upper curve is 2 power x and lower curve is this parabola 2x minus x square t. So 2 power x integral is 2 power x by log 2. 2x integral is x square plus x cube by 3 with 0 to 2. When I put 0, everything is, this is something. Okay, let us put 2. It will be 4 by log 2 minus 4 plus 8 by 3. When I put 0, it is 1 by log 2. 4 by log 2 minus 1 by log 2 is 3 by log 2. and then minus 12, so minus 4 by 3. Okay, so this is also quite simple because one curve is completely above the other and we have limit. So second graph is a parabola. So how to draw any parabola? One method is you make perfect square and then use it in the form of y minus k whole square equal to 4 into x minus h, or x minus h whole square to 4 into y minus k. Another method is whenever you have y equal to x minus alpha into x minus beta into a, simply draw alpha, beta. If a is positive, it will be a parabola like this. And if a is negative, it will be a parabola like this. That's it. So here the roots are 0 and 2. I wrote x minus 0 into x minus 2 with a minus, so downward parabola. All right. So once again, we are just doing different questions just for the experience only. Otherwise, theory is very simple for this chapter. By the way, anybody downloaded NTA app? Tried any exam? NTA Abhyas. Anybody downloaded at least?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Anybody gave any exam? Who is that? Who gave the exam? No one. Anyway, Sunday we have time, we can do it. Mm-hmm. At least one exam, if you write, you can see after exam, what are the different things that they're providing, solutions and explanations and all. Okay, so 43. Mm-hmm. X equal to A divides the area bounded by x-axis and the part of the curve and ordinate into equal part. What is the t? Okay, so y equal to 1 plus 8 by x square. 8 by x square is a decreasing function. This is one line, and 8 by x square is like this. This is 0 comma 0. This is 1 on y axis. This is a graph of y equal to 1 plus 8 by x square. When x is tending to infinity, 8 by x square will tend to 0, this will tend to 1. So it is trying to touch that y equal to 1 line between 2 and 4. So I have x equal to 2 and x equal to 4. There is some area. Now what is that we have to find is there is one more line x equal to a I have to draw such a way that this area and this area are equal. Do you think, will it be 3 or more than 3 or less than 3? The answer. I want to draw a line x equal to a dividing this whole region into two equal parts. Okay. So that a value, will it be 3, more than 3 or less than 3?
Less than.
Obviously less than 3, because if I take 3 itself, left area is more and right area is less. So I have to move towards little left. So definitely answer is some number between 2 to 3. You have to find that. So I can say this area to be half of the total. So you can say integral 2 to a, area under the curve 1 plus 8 pi x square dx should be same as integral a to 4, 1 plus 8 pi x square dx. Or you can say both of them should be half of integral 2 to 4, 1 plus 8 pi x square dx.
This area should be same and they should be half of the total.
You can only, you can equate these two or you can equate this and this, not at all. What's the integral here? X, this integral is minus 8 pi x with limits 2 to e. Coming to this, half of x minus 8 pi x with limits 2 to 4. I can bring this 2 here. And I substitute a, it is a minus 8 pi x. Minus 2 times and I substitute 2, 2 minus 8 pi. Here, and I substitute 4, 4 minus 8 by 4, minus 2 minus 8 by 2. So this is 2a minus 16 by a minus 2 minus 4 minus 2 plus 4. This side 4 minus 2 is 2, that is 2 minus 4 is minus 2, so another plus 2. So 4 and 4 can cancel, it became 0. So I simply got a square equal to 8, which implies a equal to root 8, little less than root 9. So I'm getting a equal to root 8, 2 root. Okay, so this is also like simple area only, just on they drawn one more line saying it is divided into two equal parts. That's by chance somebody, or I think you have access to Android phone, but by chance if somebody doesn't have a regular access and still you want to write NTA Abhyas, I think there are some Android emulators like Knox and BlueStreak or some BlueStack or something. You can download that in the PC or laptop and then you can use any Android app there. Some of you are aware of this Android emulators, right?
Yes, sir.
Oh. So if somebody is not able to download this NTA Abhyas app because they're not having phone with them for so much time, I'm sure it is possible to do in PC or laptop with this emulators. But as such, NTA Abhyas did not launch any PC version of this app. Okay, any doubt anybody has regarding 43? Okay, then we'll close for today. We'll continue tomorrow. All right. So those who are attending KVPA class, we'll meet in the evening. Okay, thank you. Though somebody is copying from the board, you can take a few minutes to copy.